Well, hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Sunita here. So yes, I have been gone a minute, but I'm back, I'm filming. Let's just not get into it. Life happened and we are going to film a holiday glam. I am fresh off of holiday from Morocco. Went to Marrakesh. It was an experience. But whilst I was there, I was doing some simple glam. I always bring all my makeup, like I'm going to do my makeup like I do at home, and I never do. But I really loved the makeup that I was doing, so I thought I would show you. So let's get started. As my moisturiser doesn't have SPF in it, when you're on holiday, you've got to get your SPF in. So I just use a small amount of that and I get that on my face. And luckily, this one doesn't actually leave a white cast like some do. And I have tested a lot of sun cream because I don't wear SPF that much. But it's been drilled into me and drilled into me that I need to wear some more SPF. So we're trying to incorporate that in our life. I live in the UK in London and it's not always got any sunshine. It's normally cold and rainy, but I really just want to incorporate this into my normal routine. I'm going in with day cream. This is the Elemis Pro Collagen Marine Cream, and I love this cream so much. A little goes a long way, and it's nice on your skin. And it also just hydrates the skin so that your skin looks nice and glowy, because this look is going to be without foundation. I said it on my days. Without foundation. Because my skin is being really good to me at the moment. I've got just a little spot here and I think I've got one on my forehead somewhere. But yeah, breakouts have been to a minimum. So that's all nicely worked into the skin. So let's start. Well, we are prepping. Let's carry on. Next item I'm going to use is this new product that I found in Superdrug, actually. It's from Botanical Lab. It's the Willow Bark Pore Minimiser. Instant blurring effect with botanical extracts. And it's also vegan friendly and anti-blemish clear skin. So I've been using that because I've got a few pores here on my cheeks. But it also helps to give you a nice matte look. So I just like to put it in the areas that I tend to get a little bit shiny, and also to just reduce those pores of mine. And I literally just work it in. And you can feel like it's lightweight on the skin, but you can feel that it's got some sort of like tackiness to it, and that it's gonna hold your makeup in place. And because I'm only gonna be wearing concealer, that's gonna really help to like help it sink into the skin and make it look a lot like skin like and not too thick. Working it in. Do you like my henna? I got some henna done while I was there, and the lady put some glitter on it as well, which obviously rubbed off, but it was just beautiful. It's starting to come off now, but yeah, it was really, really nice. And it makes you think like, oh, I love a hand tattoo. I quite like getting a glimpse of my hand and forgetting that it's there, and it's just like, oh. So I totally understand why people get like hand tattoos as well. So that's nicely worked into the skin. We're looking hydrated, we're looking bright, and that's what we're looking for when we're on holiday. So now I'm gonna go in and do eyebrows. I'm using this new product. It's for Sourcil Precision eyebrow pencil from Bourjois in the number 3 Chatain. And I've gone with a lighter color now. So it's more of like a chocolatey, couldn't even see that. So literally looks like my skin, and I'm preferring this. I was using a darker, like a more deeper eyebrow pencil, but this now works for me so much better, and I'm just gonna show you how. So my eyebrows are a hot mess at the moment, but I've learnt this new little trick to make my eyebrows look on point, and I kind of knew how to do it already. It just looks much better when you obviously you can seal it. So I'm just gonna get my mirror in a little bit closer. Okay, here we go. So what I like to do, I'm gonna zoom you guys in. So you see the natural sharpness. So I always take it just in the middle here, and I like to bring it up. Where you can see that I've got my overgrown hair, I just tend to just stay on top because I know what kind of shape I am looking for. And I kind of do it. When you see this, you're going to be like, she looks mad. But bear with me. Stick with it. It all just does fall into place nicely. And I'm just taking it out. This is as long as I want. I extend it a little bit more than where my hairs are. And we're going to make that a nice, like, fine point. And a new trick I've learned is to overdraw eyebrows. So I knew about overdrawing lips. I don't do that personally. But overdrawing eyebrows, I was like, what? But I'm telling you, this works. So my eyebrow finishes here, and I take it up just literally a millimeter. It's so minute, you can't even tell. And it just gives me the illusion of a thicker eyebrow. And then we go in, and we just do it, spread the product through the eyebrow. Okay, so you're looking at it and you're like, Sneeto, what is this? This don't look good. I ain't going out like that. Then you take your concealer. I have actually been using the Revolution stick foundation to conceal with my eyebrows. Taking a small concealer brush, little bit of product. It looks like a lot. It's a full coverage foundation, so it does look like I've got a lot of product on there, but it's gonna work. So then we take it where my arch would be, is where I start to conceal, and we're just taking small motions. I am covering up that extra hairs that wouldn't normally be there if my eyebrows were done. And we're just placing the product. We're not blending or anything like that yet. And then we take it and then we blend downwards into the eye socket. So that already there is giving you your shape. And I like to raise my eyebrows when I'm doing them as well, so I can really get right in there and really smooth down those excess hairs. Again, I'm just being lazy. You could just pluck them out. I don't got time. So then, on top, we're going again where my arch will begin. And we're just taking it slightly on top. And then we're bringing that down to create that lovely sharp bit at the end. And just spread that away. You don't need to worry. And because this is my foundation shade as well, it isn't going to look crazy or harsh or too bright in my eyebrow. So then take it down, just getting rid of that excess at the end, because we want to get that nice like sharpness point at the end, really blending it in and keeping it nice and consistent. So it might be worth just using your foundation shade instead of going in with a concealer shade. And I'm just tidying it up from the bottom to the top. You see, not so crazy. Okay, see, and it doesn't look bad. Look at this eyebrow and then look at this eyebrow, and you can kind of see that difference right there. I've just created a nice larger eyebrow and a fuller eyebrow. So let's move on. So that's both eyebrows done and complete. Let's move on to the next step. So I'm going in with concealer. I am using the e.l.f. 16 hour camo concealer, and I'm literally just going to use that on my eyes just here, just to camouflage my deep tear ducts, is what I like to call them. So not a lot, just a little bit, touch on the nose, done. Let's not forget a little bit of the forehead, tiny bit, and then yeah, done. And then we're gonna just take our foundation brush and we're just going to pat that into place. My concealer isn't a brightening concealer, even though it looks as bright. I would normally powder, but I didn't use any powder for this look whatsoever. And I wasn't greasy at the end of the day, so I didn't think I needed it. And I think actually that this concealer is supposed to be a matte concealer as well, which probably does help with it. So when you're choosing your concealer, just go with what your skin would like. And I'm just trying to obviously just make sure that I'm not going to look too uneven. My skin is really healthy at the moment. I have been really taking care of it. I've been drinking lots of water. I've been eating healthily. I've been doing a nice skincare routine. So it has really paid off, and that's why I felt on holiday that I didn't need too much. And you can see, look how far that spread, that tiny little bit that I had here, look how far it spread, right? And it just helps to uplift the eye and just give it a little bit more je ne sais quoi. So keeping it right in there, just little patting motions, and pat that into the skin. And because it spreads so far as well, I'm just taking it down so it all just looks even. Look how like uplifted this side looks. And this side is just waiting for that uplift, that little bit of brightening. Not too much, not too crazy. Doesn't feel heavy on the skin. Like when you're on holiday and it's really hot, like we had like 34 degrees, 35 degrees out there. Nighttime it was 19 degrees. So it was really hot. So I just didn't want all of that on my face. Didn't want it to be too heavy. And so you go, and it just evens me out, and you can just take it and just, because I'm just patting it, and you can just pat into the rest of the skin if needed, and you can use it as like a light foundation. Maybe it's more like I'm using my concealer as foundation, but whatever, it's concealer being used. That's it, and everything just falls into place. You see the eyebrows looked a little bit crazy before, but now they kind of like come into the skin and it all works. This lighter color is working a dream for me. It makes my eyes look brighter. It makes me feel less like I'm heavy on my eyes around that area. So yeah, that's great. I only bronzed on my first day, but I love a bit of bronzer as well, just to complement the skin and just to bring it back, bring that warmth back into the skin. And I think that actually was like my best day when I did use I'm going with the Fenty bronzer in Mocha Mami. I'm just gonna warm up the skin, keep it nice and light, keep it fresh, keep it golden and lovely. You see, it just brings it back. Just like to pat that around, pat it on my chin, jawline snatch. See? Boom, that is it. Then obviously, piece de resistance. Everybody loves a little bit of highlighter. I'm going in with the Colourpop highlighter. This is in the shade Pose, and this is a loose powder. So I like to just dip the tip of my brush in it, pat off all that excess, because we just want to go over a light wash. And then I'm just going to dip it on the high points, bam bam, high points. Bam bam. Bit on the nose. Really, really conscious about how much I'm putting on. Let's keep it light. And then I just go in and just blend that. You guys looked for a second and thought, oh, that, but she crazy. She's about to leave that unblended. But we go nowhere unblended. See that? Just liven up that area, give you that glow. Love highlighter on the nose. Get a bit on that tip. Use the excess on the forehead. Gives you that like, ooh, sun-kissed vibe when you don't have a tan. I didn't really tan, I was not really sunbathing, and we were constantly moving and walking around or doing stuff, so I didn't get a chance to tan, which I'm not really bothered about. I just gave myself the illusion of that sun-kissed vibe. A little bit on there. If you want, add a little bit more, however much you want. I was very, very, very subtle with it. But if you're the highlight queen, take it to the top. That's all I can say. Do you? I was done basically with skin. This was my base. I didn't wear any mascara. I didn't wear any eyeliner. But for this video purposes, I am going to. But I also had a nice lip on, and that was me done. So let me just put some mascara and eyeliner on, and then we'll get into the lip. So I'm going in with ye olde favourite mascara, and I would literally, the first day, it was just like nothing, like barely there, just let my eyes kind of like pop. But this could be a nice easy beach look. Maybe you're going to a pool party, like it was so easy. Then I go in with my cream eyeliner. This is from NYX. This is their retractable eyeliner, and this is just in brown. Boom, done. So my favourite lip combo while I was on holiday, it was the Fenty Gloss Bomb and literally this Primark eyeliner, in shade Toffee. So I was lining all my lips with it. It's like a soft brown with, I'd say it's got like, I don't know, hints in it. I'm just gonna line the whole lip for it as my lipstick. And then we're gonna go on with the gloss bomb, just a touch. Nice and see, and this is literally it. This is what I did on holiday. So I'm just going to give myself some nice glam hair, show you what you can do for your little pool party, and we're gonna end, because done. So guys, this is the final look. I put some cute little puffs in my hair. I put these gorgeous little clips in, because clips are all the rage, and they just make a hairstyle just look a little bit more expensive. I got some of my gold hoops on, and yeah, this is me. This was me for my entire holiday, except for the first day when I did put on a full beat. This is just my go-to quick 10 minutes, doesn't take any time at all. You don't feel like you've got loads and loads of makeup on, so it's just so easy, especially when you're in the heat. But obviously if you want to put more makeup on, that's you, do you. But yes, this is my pool party every day walking round. You might want to glam it up more in the evenings, but telling you, this was just me for my entire holiday. So let's not forget, got to try this look with some sunglasses. Oh, bam! Boo! I was feeling myself, I'm telling you, when I've got my sunglasses on, it's like, you can't tell me nothing. But yeah, this is glam. Guys, don't forget, like my video, subscribe, come back whenever I film again, because I'm here to stay. And I'll see you on my next video. Bye! When you